Paramahansam in a full form, Pratishtapana and Sarpan. Yesterday we worshipped Saraswati Ma. Today Durga Ma. Chandika Homa is going on. Purnahuti will be at 9 o'clock. All of you please join us for the Purnahuti in Prarthana Mandir. Bhakti and celebration. Celebration is necessary in our lives to ward off all the routine hang-ups. Every day we come in the morning, do yogasana, do our studies, and all for housewives, routine cooking. But on celebrations, we have very special things happening, and system gets totally diverted, totally charged with greater energy. So we have several celebrations in our culture, and through that we all come together. Family comes together, country comes together. Now, for example, the Navaratri, the entire country is charged with this Shakti. So we all pray to the divine Shakti that all our internal, personal, family and national desires get satisfied. What is bhakti? I'll give you two examples. How bhakti can be used in therapy for healing ourselves, and how bhakti can be used for bringing about changes outside. How we can invoke the divine within ourselves to bring about major changes outside. One participant was here, Bengali. We have to remember Bengali is this week. Our Bengali Durga has come here. So Bengali girl in her 20s, grown up to be a vice president of a company, IT professional. She had severe back pain. For almost 6 months, she could not go to her duties. She would go, come back, lot of back pain, and she comes here. And her company, she is so important for her company. They said, you just go heal yourself. Don't worry about the duration of your therapy also. Heal yourself and come back. Of course, going through all the regular medical treatments and advices on surgery, non-wise on surgery, she finally held about our center and she came and landed here. She was here for about 3 to 4 weeks. And at the end of it, she was 100% cured, totally zero pain. She was ready to go back to her duty. When she was about to get back on the last day, on Thursday, I asked her, what do you think has helped you? We do so many things from 5:30 a.m. to 10 p.m. We do meditation, asanas 3 times a day, pranayama, meditation. Those days we didn't have Ayurveda or naturopathy also. No outside agency, everything she has to do herself. Physiotherapy, naturopathy, Ayurveda, you are a passive person, somebody else does it for you. Those days it was totally yoga only. So I asked her, what helped you? She said, I was expecting maybe special technique or something. But she says, it was the evening bhajan session and the lecture on bhakti yoga that made all the difference. I was curious. I asked her, how, please tell me. See, I am a Bengali girl. We are all very emotional people. But now I am an IT professional. Always left brain, left brain, left brain. Perform organization, management, strict intellectual work, logical thinking. So I have grown like that. Bengalis are also very intelligent also, so she could grow to great heights very quickly. So, but what I realized after coming here is the only thing that I have to do to heal myself is to do prashamana, calming down my mind, relaxing my mind, going into a state of total rest to your nervous system, rest to my back pain, rest to my back area, and there is really no big disc problem, it is all my muscle spasm. So, rest to the nervous system. I can see how stressed out I was and I was suppressing my stresses. So to do prashamana, you taught us all different parts, Raja Yoga, Kama Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga. When I heard about Bhakti Yoga, I thought I am a professional, intellectual, and what is this Bhakti? So Kama is there, we all go and go to her, pray to her, and to the God, cure me. It was not interesting. Why should I ask God? God is so powerful. If Durga Ma is such a great mother, mother of the universe, my mother is better than this great mother of Durga, because my mother knows what I want. Without asking, she gives me. If there are two children in the house, if one child is demanding, 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 and she has made sandesh, she will first give it to the non-asking child. Hey, wait, I say, she is keeping quiet, I give her the sandesh first, then I give you. So my mother is that way, more kind, more caring, more giving. Without asking, she gives. What is this Vishwama who can give only if I ask? I never used to understand all this. So I never used to be interested in bhakti. But what I heard for the first time here in Prashanti, I understood from Artha Bhakti Sutra and all the lecture series, bhakti is not that God is sitting somewhere there and she has to wait for me to go and ask for some grace and then something happens to me. But bhakti is my bhava inside, my feeling inside. Parama prema rupa bhakti. Bhakti is what I feel inside. Prema bhava, all of us know. What is prema? I love my friend, I love my mother loves me. We are all very familiar with the normal love. So this is parama love, parama prema, highest form of love. So it is something here, not there. So it is then Durga Ma's murti or picture or godhood state becomes less important than what I feel in the form of love. So now I understood that to convert my love for my mother, my biological mother, and move on to make it highest form of love, where I offer my love to the entire universe, Parama Prema, God becomes a very important agency, because to love the entire universe, we personify the universal consciousness in the form of Durga Ma and offer all our love to Mother, who is the manifestation of the incarnation or the representation of the universal Shakti in the entire universe. So now it became very easy for me. So I love my mother. Similarly, I offer my love to Durga also. But it's not easy. I can love my mother. But how can I love this universal mother? It needs sadhana, it needs practice, it needs understanding, it needs tuning. So in the bhajan session in the evening, I used to enjoy that feeling, that raga, that bhava, that tada, that feeling that mother is with me, exactly like my own mother, but Durga Ma is sitting in front of me. So I used to enjoy that, and through that I could go into real emotional management, and all my deep-seated emotional needs, all my emotional separations, all my emotional conflicts. And she is in her late 20s, conflict about personal relationship, marital issues, all those also must have been bothering her. So all that I could resolve, and enter into the deep state of pure feeling of intense love, where I just feel like giving. So now when I go back to my company also, I will not be in the demanding mode, but I will be in the giving mode. So this has cured my back pain. Look at the prashamana that can happen at a very deep level if we really go into that parama prema bhava. Second example. How this immense bhakti can can be transferred and bring about changes, all that Samadhi Pada that we read in Patanjali Yoga Sutra. There was an orthopedic surgeon who was very well trained and finished his master's degree and working in a big company, a big nursing home. And one day when he was doing his surgery, he fainted. And then he was taken to NIMHANS, and in NIMHANS they diagnosed that there is an AV malformation. That means there is a bunch of arteries in the brain which is extremely dangerous, which ruptured a little bit luckily, and a little bleed happened. And in fact, if you see somebody instantaneously, young people dying suddenly because of some major thing, we suspect AV malformation, because congenitally there will be an abnormality, bunch of arteries. It may bleed any time, and a big bleed and can give the person immediately. Luckily, he was in the hospital, which was a small bleed, and so we had to rush him to the hospital, and every investigation was done, and the AV malformation was detected, and they said it's a very dangerous type of thing. It can bleed any time and kill you, and it is of a moderate size, it's neither too big nor too small. So all investigations, all consultants, all therapies, there is a treatment. We go and then do clotting of those arteries or do laser treatment. But this boy's therapy was that neither it was small enough for laser treatment, nor was it in a position where they could do surgery and do something inside by getting into it. They are in a very precarious condition. What to do, what to do, what to do? Only thing is, you cannot do any more surgeries. You have to stay at home, do nothing. If you do all these hammering carpentry work of an orthopedic surgeon, it may bleed any time. So what happens? So we went on discussing, meeting several consultants. In fact, his sister was in the UK. We sent him to UK. And in UK, she went on inquiring from various centers, big centers, Glasgow Center, London Center. Everybody said the same thing as in NIMHANS. He is not fit for neither laser treatment nor for open surgery. What to do? It is too big for laser treatment, and we cannot enter into it and touch it because it's in a vital area. It may cause a lot of neurological damage. What to do? What to do? What to do? And he is an orthopedic surgeon. That is his profession. He can't do anything else. So once it so happened that when we went on inquiring all over the UK, it was a very small, remote, small town in UK, where one neurologist was very popular for this, and we met him. He said, I know this is a very simple thing. I will do the surgery, bring him tomorrow. I will do the laser treatment. I have done many such cases. It's not a big case at all. And he did the thing and it was done. Can you believe that the day after, the day we heard this news, her mother died here. His mother died here. What was she doing? His mother, she is staying in Prashantra also for her diabetes and back pain and all that. I knew her. She used to stay in one of these cottages. She was an intense bhakta. Shiva. Shiva Bhakti. You know, this Lingayat community in our country, they do a lot of Shiva Bhakti. And their way of doing it is they hold the Shiva Lingam, the Shita Lingam in their hand and do Thataka, and then go into deep meditation through that. And I used to see her sitting in the cottage. She won't come to some classes. Her therapist would complain why she is not coming to class. I would go into her room. She is going in deep meditation. So she used to talk. I am very much worried about my son, but I know Shiva will make it all right. I know whatever you people are going to search and go for him, I know Shiva will do the right thing for him. She was so deeply convinced that it will happen. Nobody knew. We as medical professionals were struggling. No answer, no answer. And that boy is very much worried. But here is the mother who is deeply, deeply, deeply into meditation, praying only for what Shakti, she must have turned herself to the universal consciousness through the Shiva Bhakti, and one small single thought, that's what we read in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, Trayame Katra Sanyamaha, she is doing dharana, she is doing dhyana, tuning herself to the deep divine Shakti, the Bhava, and through that Bhava, she just puts one single thought in the clean lake, clean, quiet lake state of deep loving mind, where the mother's love is so pure, so clean, so selfless, that that has taken action. And probably she, her wish was fulfilled by offering her life for the son. We read a lot about this, even in Aurangzeb's life, we hear that father prayed for the son's life and gave his life. This is possible only if the mind becomes so pure, so clean, that outside changes can be brought about. In fact, we used to have Lakshmi Amma, who is the founder of this campus. Her only method was that there is a big problem in the campus, she would go into deep meditation. Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram. May this problem be abated. And then somehow, somewhere, some effort come those days. Our major problem was financial. Somewhere, some money would come, something would happen. So this was her technique itself. She always used to use for herself, for her hearing also, she used bhakti. But in fact, for her hearing, she used jnana yoga. But for the betterment of prashanti, the growth of prashanti, the vishwa prashanti, for the betterment of the country, she always used to tune herself to divine Rama Shakti. In fact, she was an incarnation of Rama Bhakti. And she would just delude herself into it. Hey Ram, you are going to do it, I don't know how. And totally get into deep samadhi experiences. All those two, three samadhi experiences, Savijara Samadhi, Savitarka Samadhi, all that she had experienced through her sadhana. And one seemed to go into the deep, pure, clean, selfless wish. Your wish can be fulfilled. That's why we pray to Mother that may our wish be fulfilled. What wish will be fulfilled? Selfless wish. So why am I praying for this? Because it is a selfless wish for the betterment of my family, betterment of my society, betterment of my country. If you wish in that deep bhava. And first step is to get yourself healthy and happy. Come out of the monkey mind problem. My monkey mind puts me into anxiety. Oh man, no more monkey mind. I am going to be confident. This is the first thing you have to pray for, Durga Ma. And then go on to wish for the others, society and other places. So today is the Durgashtami day, when we are all going to be tuned, to be praying to that mother's love. It's very easy because we all love our mother. Our mother loves us. So just think of Durga Ma and motherly love for her and see how this divine energy can charge you with enormous shakti, enormous strength, enormous courage, enormous positivity, enormous light within, enormous healer within, and see how the disease can get cured also, how our limitations can get corrected.